say good morning and thanks organizers for inviting me to have a long flight from Houston to come here and give a talk. So this is my talk, Indirect Techniques in Nuclear Astrophysics. So understanding of the origin of the elements is one of the key scientific questions facing researchers in nuclear physics and astronomy in 21st century. Significant progress on our understanding of nuclear synthesis owing to the development of different indirect techniques, what I'm going to talk about, used to determine reaction rates and new facilities that are expanding the possibilities for both direct and indirect studies. So the major indirect methods are Coulomb dissociation, was invented by Bauer and Carlos Bertolani, who is here, in 1985. Then ANC method, it was suggested by me and Natasha Timofeyuk in 1990, it's a mistake. And then the Trojan horse method was suggested by Bauer in 86 and modified by Claudio Spitaleri, who is the chair of our conference in 1999. And since that, the local group started working on Trojan horse method, and this group is a main driving force in the world advancing this method. And then resonance scattering and inverse kinematics on thick target was suggested by Vlad Goldberg and his colleagues in 1990. I would like to draw attention that recently there was a review paper published in Report on Progress in Physics. It was published in fall 2014. And these are co-authors and two people, Marco Lacagnato from Catania Lab, who is secretary of the conference, and Claudio Spitaleri. Carlos Bertolani also here, and me, and only Bob Tribble is not here. So if people are interested in direct technique, they can read this review. Now, I will talk today only about two techniques. I have only 25 minutes to talk about, so ANC and Trojan horse. I'm too humble to talk about Coulomb dissociation in front of Carlos, who is the author of this technique. I'm too inferior in this area compared to Carlos. So from general principle, one can obtain that in the K-plane, S matrix has poles corresponding to bound states and resonances. And these residue in these poles are expressed in terms of the ANC. From other side, this is a pure axiomatic approach, I would say. But from other side, ANCs are the amplitudes of the overlap functions, which was discovered by Cramers in 1938 and Heisenberg in 1946. So they connected the wave function description and asymptotic behavior of the wave bound state wave function with the residue of the poles. And it was a very important achievement. So the ANC, or asymptotic normalization coefficient, is a fundamental nuclear characteristic equivalent to the renormalized coupling constant in the field theory. Now, if we use S matrix and approach a pole, it does not matter, bound state or resonance, it has a pole in the momentum plane, and the coefficient or residue in the pole is ANC squared. This is eta is a Coulomb parameter, and L is the orbital momentum. Now, this exactly was found by Cramers and Heisenberg and extended to the Coulomb. They found only for neutral case when one of the particles is neutral, A or A, and Perelomov in the former Soviet Union in 1966 extended this for the Coulomb interaction. This is a Perelomov equation, actually. Then, so For both cases, bound state and resonances, the residue is expressed in terms of the ANCs. So for resonances, ANCs connected can be expressed in terms of resonance partial width. So for resonances, ANCs directly observable from experiments. This connection between ANC and resonance width was done by me and Dalinsky in 1980, and that is the equation, mu is a reduced mass, k is a resonant momentum, and this is a potential scattering phase shift. Now, the connection between ANC and subthreshold resonance width, I am talking about bound state, which is located very close to the threshold, so the tail of this bound state wave function can be seen in the continuum. In this case, bound state works as a resonance, and it was found in 1999 with Bob Tribble in our paper. So, and then, now these two great Soviet scientists who actually revived ANC, and contemporary stage of ANC is due to Landau, in Russian, Lev Davidovich Landau, and my senior advisor, Yossi Solomon Shapira. He worked under Landau guidance, and what Landau did? Landau suggested in the 50s that Feynman diagrams would be the major future tool in elementary particle physics and nuclear physics, and he contributed extensively on his own by researching analytical properties and singularities of diagrams. Shapiro, who worked under Landau, developed after that non-relativistic Feynman diagram techniques, and vertex form factors were related with overlap functions or with ANCs. So, if we have virtual decay of nucleus F into two body channel A plus A, then the overlap projection of the bound state wave function of nucleus F on the channel A plus A, where we integrate over the, all the internal coordinates of A and A, is a function of the distance between an A, and it's called overlap function, and that's what we measure in nuclear reaction experiments. The asymptotic behavior of the overlap function, radial, I took only radial part here, at distances larger than interaction radius is proportional to the Whittaker function, it's the Coulomb parameter, orbital momentum, bound state wave number, and the amplitude is ANC. So if the reaction is peripheral, we measure ANC. Now, recently, the first review paper was published at Moscow State University in 1977 by my micro advisors Blachintsev and Dalinsky, and application of ANC method for nuclear astrophysics was suggested by me and Natasha Semyonov again, it's a mistake, in 1990. And when I moved to the Cyclotron Institute in 1994, I gave that name ANC, asymptotic normalization coefficient, which is now in PAX, is used everywhere. Before we used coupling constant, nuclear vector constant, asymptotic coefficient, normalization coefficient. Now, ANC can be used for radiative capture reaction. For example, if we have radiative capture reaction. This is initial scattering wave function. This is electromagnetic transition operator, and here it should be overlap function. If due to the Coulomb barrier, reaction is peripheral, so pushed out, and also electromagnetic transition operator contains RL, R is the distance between interacting particle, then it pushes also metric, integrant in the matrix element to the external region, and we can replace overlap function, but it's asymptotic. So ANC comes out as an overall normalization of the astrophysical factor, and that is what using the ANC method. Now, I am not going to elaborate any more ANC technique. I just only, always people ask how reliable ANC technique. So I want to show three striking examples where ANC results can be compared with lunar measurement, taking into account that ANC were predicted results before lunar date experiment. So it's not vice versa, lunar date and we fitted. No, it was opposite. So the, here is a CNO cycle, which consists of three cycles. The first part is a CN cycle in classification of Klaus, Rolfs, and Rodney. And as you see here, the nucleus which has the highest charge is oxygen 15, and there is no resonant capture, direct capture. So it is a bottleneck. And then the next, after oxygen 15 decays, nitrogen 15 can go back to the cycle, or after capturing proton can go to oxygen 16. It's a leak from CN cycle to the bicycle and tricycle. Now, this is the result of the ANC technique. We measured ANC in Prague and then calculated the astrophysical factor. And this is later on measurements by Luna. So you can see the agreement. Now, the second, this is the second reaction is that one, which I just showed, the leak. And these are Notre Dame, Notre Dame Luna data, and the fit using Karmatrix where the ANC is correctly fitted. So this is a result obtained by Notre Dame Luna, and this is the ANC which we obtained 2 years before. And finally, I'm going to always discuss lithium-6, lithium problem. Lithium-7, shortage of lithium-7 is called the first lithium problem, and the second is lithium-6. And the crucial reaction is this one. However, in 1996, Cecil predicted that the astrophysical factor for this reaction would be never measured directly because it's too small. Nevertheless, Luna succeeded recently to do experiment in these 2 points where yesterday Antonio from Luna, Antonio Caccioli, right? He showed these 2 measurements, and the red line is ANC prediction, which has been done in 1995. So you see the agreement. So I showed you 3 results where ANC, now 25 years of experimental attempts to measure astrophysical factor for this reaction at the Big Bang energy, Big Bang up to 400 keV, finally succeeded by Luna experiment, which confirms the ANC prediction done in 1995 and 2000 later on. Now I'm done with ANC, I'm going to Trojan horse. So the Trojan horse, as I told, is the main tool which is developed by our host here in Catania National Lab. What is that? Assume that we are interested in the astrophysical reaction X plus A going to C plus C. The method was suggested by Bauer, but it was not workable until Claudio Spitaleri modified it and practically realized it. So if you have astrophysical energies here and the entry channel, it is impossible to measure, or extremely difficult due to the Coulomb barrier. Instead, it was suggested to use A as a Trojan horse particle. The idea is that A is accelerated above the Coulomb barrier. So it penetrates, carrying inside a poison, particle X. Once it's penetrated through the barrier, because if the relative energy is higher than the barrier, then the wave function of the relative motion will not disappear at very small distances between A and A. So when A penetrated behind the barrier, it breaks, and leaving X with very low energy interacting with A, and the rest of the energy is taken by spectator S. So that is the condition. The relative kinetic energy between A and A should be higher than the Coulomb barrier. But because particle A can penetrate very close to A, so bringing X, there is no barrier between X and A. And this is the main advantage of the Trojan horse. Okay, so no barrier here, it means that if we can measure, if we do direct measurements of this reaction, in this case, we would have Coulomb barrier in the initial channel, and we fail to do it if reaction, if energy is very low. Now, when we have Trojan horse, we use this surrogate reaction, and we try to measure subreaction. There is no barrier here, so you enhance significantly the cross-section, removing the barrier. Moreover, you directly obtain astrophysical factor. Usually, the Q reaction is high, and in this case, the particle here automatically above the barrier. Now, another important problem and another important condition that the relative momentum between spectator and X should be close to zero. Zero is the quasi-free kinematics. Or if it's order of zero, then according to uncertainty principle, the distance between S and X can be very large beyond of nuclear interaction radius. It means that S is really can be treated as spectator and it does not influence on the interaction of X and A. Now, another important condition. This is a basic Trojan horse condition. The particle X is a virtual. We pay a price. What means virtual? It means that energy and momentum of these particles are not related, as usually E is equal P square over 2m. That is why the relative kinetic energy here and momentum also are not related, and that's how they connected. Assume that we want to measure energies which are about kVs, 100 kVs, and binding energy we use, for example, deuteron is 2 MeV. So this factor should be larger than 2.2 MeV, what means that this factor is significantly deviates from energy. It means that it's really off-shell process. Now, by changing kinematics, for example, changing the angle of S, we can bring this factor down to energies less than binding energy. So Trojan horse allows not only measure at very low energies, but even measure at energies which are negative, so subthreshold resonances or even loosely bound state, bound state can be measured using Trojan horse. Now, here is a expression, unfortunately, here is some cutoff. Now, assume that I consider on shell just the reaction which we want to, this reaction. So initially we have scattering wave function, interaction potential, and then final scattering wave function. And if I use the prior form, then the exact wave function in the final channel, outgoing particles, this is interaction potential, here. And this is a plane wave times the bound state wave function of A. I neglect the structure of particle X, assuming it's nucleon. Now, the Trojan horse matrix element looks the same, but instead of K, we have P, which is virtual momentum. K is related to energy, P is not, P is much larger. But if we would use very high energy, then P and K will be very close, because if at very high energy, then Px square over 2mx much larger than binding energy, and we have approximation that Trojan horse matrix element coincides with exact on shell, and it's called impulse approximation, but Trojan horse is being performed at very low energy, so we cannot use it. But we can apply another approach. We can use so-called two-potential equation. Two-potential means that we subtract here Coulomb potential, and instead of plane wave, we get distorted wave. This is exact matrix element. At very low energies in the initial channel, the Coulomb distorted wave has penetration factor. This penetration factor guides the whole energy dependence of the matrix element. If we remove it, we will get astrophysical factor, and the rest is where copper tilde is a Coulomb wave function with removed penetration factor, and this behaves very closely to the plane wave in the Trojan horse. And this fact can be used to connect the Trojan horse matrix element and on shell, and what is mostly used in, by Catania group. Now, I will show you two examples. Yes, okay. One example is a recent paper published in PhysRevC by Claudio Spitaleri and his collaborators. It's a boron 10 plus proton going to alpha 0 to beryllium 7. That is an astrophysical reaction which to be measured and for which Trojan horse can be used. So, for example, deuteron plus deuteron is a Trojan horse particle. So here is a short description that this reaction for Bohr astrophysical factor for this reaction without any barrier can be was measured for the first time from 100 kV down to 5 kV. Now I will show you what I did not tell, but I tell you now. The problem is that there are two barriers. One is the Coulomb barrier, which is generated by Coulomb repulsion between interacting particles. This is removed by removing penetration factor. But there is another barrier, it's which generated by electrons surrounding, atomic electrons. And this, while the nuclear Coulomb barrier works by depressing the cross-section, the electron clouds increase the cross-section. Here, you see different direct measurements, including the measurement on the thick target. And here you see the crosses, stars are Trojan horse measurement. Now, in Trojan horse, Catania group measures only energy dependence. To get absolute value, they normalize the data to available direct data at high energies. Here they normalize between 100 and about 30 kV, and then you see the direct data goes up, because, and that is the effect of the electron screening. Electron screening increases cross-section. And Trojan horse goes, as usually, the astrophysical factor for Bohr nuclei. By comparing these two results, we can estimate electron screening potential, what usually done in all the papers by Catania lab. So here is reference to experimental data which were used by the Catania group. Now I am going to show another very instructive picture for application of the Trojan horse, which was published just recently in this paper with Marco Cagnata and collaborators from Catania lab. And what is interesting here? This reaction is very important for understanding of nucleosynthesis of fluorine-19 because it leads to destruction. So abundance of fluorine-19 is crucially depending on this reaction. Here is the direct measurements recently done in 2013 by Lombarda from Napoli, right? The red are Trojan horse measurements. The direct measurements stop here at 600 kV, but we need to know data at this region, which is a region of astrophysical interest. And you see the Trojan horse show very important resonance at 113 kV, which was not seen. It was the first time it was seen. That is the power of the Trojan horse. The Trojan horse data were normalized to direct data, and then we know exactly now the width and the strength of the resonance, which is the main contributor to the destruction of fluorine-19. So here was very difficult to separate at this energy. Basically, there are three resonances, triplets separated by two kV only. Now, this is the ratio of the Trojan horse reaction rate to NACRA, and you see a strong deviation at this temperature, and this is due to the presence of the newly discovered resonance. As I told you, Trojan horse allows to go as far as we need down to zero energy or even below to negative energies. So this is an explanation for this picture. As I told, that deviation, that should be one if it's, it coincides with Nakra and it is higher than one. Now it's the last transparency. So future of Trojan horse, it's my personal understanding. Maybe people for our horse have some other ideas, but what I think that application for reactions was the radioactive beams. It's the most hottest topic now to use, and we have not yet used Trojan horse for radioactive beams, but everything is ready to be used. Measuring both energy dependence and absolute values. As I told you, until now, only energy dependence of these factors were measured and then normalized to available direct data. Using more advanced theory for the analysis, it's also ready. Application for radiative capture reaction. Until now, Trojan horse was used only for rearrangement reactions. Also, Trojan horse can be very useful as an addition to direct measurements in separating overlapping resonances with LNJ, orbital momentum and spin. I want to mention again one important thing, that if you do Trojan horse experiment and you get energy spectrum, it will be different from direct measurements. Because in direct measurements, say each resonance contains penetration factor, and if L orbital momentum is high, it will be suppressed. The higher L, as Pierre showed today, before, the smaller penetration factor. In Trojan horse, penetration factor is removed. So the resonances which are suppressed in direct measurements are strongly seen in Trojan horse experiments. So it will be very useful disentangling overlapping resonances. So that's it. Thank you very much.
I would like to hear your opinion about the application of the Trojan horse method to address carbon-carbon fusion at SLR energies from a theoretical perspective.
Okay, you know, it's better to address this question to Aurora, who did presentation here, but in principle, yes, we discuss it and it's a possibility to, and moreover, it seems to me I was not here, but there was a question about subthreshold resonances. Yes, it's a perfect method to see the contribution of subthreshold resonances also. It's a very powerful technique.
Okay.
Well, with respect to your point three here on this slide, I mean, the Trojan horse method is not only, as you said, that the energy momentum relation is changed, but also, I mean, the Trojan horse is a genuine off-shell process. I mean, you cannot simply factorize an on-shell two-body reaction from a three-body reaction. In fact, I mean, to do this more exactly, there are non-DWA type amplitudes that you have to do. And I think this is, I mean, one of the problems that have to be solved for the Trojan horse method. Bauer did some work on this, but it hasn't really been implemented very well.
What is your name?
Hermann Wolter from Munich.
I see.
Yeah, I worked a lot with Tüppel, for instance. Yeah. Tüppel has done a lot of work on this, I think.
Okay, so you want my answer? Okay. yes, you are right. In more advanced theory, we need to take into account distortion effects. We need to go to more many-body theory. And one such approach has been developed and published in our paper joint with Carlos Bertolani and two my co-authors, Peng and Alisher Kadyrov from Australia. where we use surface integral of, approach and CDCC to get more advanced, but it was not yet realized because it's more complicated. And you know, experimental is always like simple, which can be done immediately.
Okay, over there.
Yes, it is just a comment on point one from Akram. And sometimes the future is even closer than what we think because the method was already applied. You missed maybe the talk from Yamaguchi-san, and so there are measurements for fluorine 18 P alpha. And the method was first time applied by spokesperson is Silvio Enriquen, and data are currently under publication. And there was also another run that you maybe remember in Texas A&M cyclotron. So when I was there, you remember. You had also a picture over there. Okay, so sometime future is very, very close. Thanks.
Great, thank you. I did not know.
Yes, just for the records of history, because we are talking about the past and the future, there are semi-classical methods, and of course you know very well, that use this surface integral method, and one can calculate a lot of things, including resonances in energy-dependent potentials and so on and so forth. One has just to be in the right conditions to apply this method.
I agree.
So the situation is not so
I did not have time to talk about all
No, of course. I mean, just for the people who don't know. Okay. And also asymptotic normalization constant, you have used it for the first time in the context of astrophysics, but it's something that exists in simple quantum mechanics. And
but I told you it was existed in 1938.
Yeah, that's
but
right.
But for astrophysics, it was appeared only in 1990.
Yes,
and
but
this
for
is a section of nuclear astrophysics.
Yes, but for what you are using it now, which is kind of induced transfer to the continuum reactions, we used it in 1988, so 2 years before you, I'm afraid.
Okay, let me correct. The first paper we published when I was a graduate student, it was the end of 60s, about.
Okay, I think we have to move on. Thank you, Akram.
Thank you.